सवितुरवरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात्। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। नमस्ते माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज थर्ड वीडियो ऑन त्रिपुरा रहस्य, द मोस्ट प्रेफर्ड बुक बाय महर्षि रमन। दिस वीडियो स्टार्ट्स विद चैप्टर 2, obligatory sense towards action, condemned and investigation recommended. 1. Ordered thus Parsurama, again saluting the son of Saint Atri with humility, began to ask. 2. Bhagwan, dear and esteemed master, O omniscient one, O son of mercy, once before, for good reason, I was furious with the kingly class. 3. 21 times I strode the land, exterminating them all, including suckling babes and those in the womb, collecting their blood in a pool. 4. My forefathers were pleased with my devotion to them. However, they ordered me to desist from such carnage. My wrath was at last appeased. 5. On hearing of the renowned Rama, the very incarnation of Hari in Ayodhya, my wrath was rekindled. Blinded by fury and proud of my prowess, I challenged him. 6. I was defeated by that great lord and my pride was humbled. However, out of his innate kindness, he let me go with my life because I was a Brahmin. 7. As I was returning, mortified by defeat, I realized the vanity of the ways of the world. 8. Unexpectedly, I met Samvarta, the lord of the Avdhutas, and instinctively recognized him to be like fire in embers. Note, says Samvarta, the brother of Brihaspati looked like a maniac wandering in the forests. ਨਾਰਦਾ ਵੰਸ ਡਾਇਰੈਕਟਿਡ ਦਾ ਐਮਪਰਰ ਨਿਵਰਿਤਾ ਟੂ ਹਿਮ ਐਂਡ ਇੰਸਟਰਕਟਿਡ ਹਿਮ ਹਾਊ ਸਮਵਰਤਾ ਕੁਡ ਬੀ ਰਿਕਗਨਾਈਜ਼ਡ ਦ ਕਿੰਗ ਅਕੋਰਡਿੰਗਲੀ ਮੈਟ ਦ ਸੇਜ ਐਂਡ ਪ੍ਰੇਡ ਫੋਰ ਹਿਜ ਹੈਲਪ ਇਨ ਦ ਪਰਫੋਰਮੈਂਸ ਆਫ ਏ ਸੈਕਰੀਫਾਈਸ ਇਨ ਵਿੱਚ ਬ੍ਰਹਸਪਤੀ ਪ੍ਰੰਪਟਿਡ ਬਾਈ ਇੰਦਰਾ ਹੈਡ ਰਿਫਿਊਜ਼ ਟੂ ਓਫੀਸੀਏਟ ਸਮਵਰਤਾ ਅਗਰੀਡ ਦੋ ਹੈਜੀਟੇਟਿੰਗਲੀ ਐਂਡ ਲੇਟਰ ਕੰਪਲੀਟਿਡ ਇਟ ਇਨ ਸਪਾਈਟ ਆਫ ਦ ਰੈਥ ਆਫ ਇੰਦਰਾ ਇੰਦਰਾ ਅਟੈਂਪਟਿਡ ਟੂ ਬ੍ਰੇਕ ਅਪ ਦ ਫੰਕਸ਼ਨ ਬਟ ਵਾਜ ਰੈਂਡਰਡ ਇੰਪੋਰਟੈਂਟ ਬਾਈ ਦ ਸੇਜ ਵਾਈਡ ਅਸ਼ਵਮੇਧਾ ਪਰਵਾ ਇਨ ਦ ਮਹਾਭਾਰਤਾ ਨਾਈਨ ਹਿਜ ਗ੍ਰੇਟਨੈਸ ਵਾਜ ਲਾਈਕ ਰੈਡ ਹੋਟ ਕੋਲ ਹਿਡਨ ਇਨ ਐਂਬਰਸ ਐਵਰੀ ਇੰਚ ਆਫ ਹਿਜ ਬੋਡੀ ਫਿਲਡ ਵਨ ਵਿਦ ਐਕਸਲਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਸੋ ਦੈਟ ਆਈ ਹੈਡ ਏ ਰਿਫਰੈਸ਼ਿੰਗ ਫੀਲਿੰਗ ਇਨ ਹਿਜ ਮੇਅਰ ਪ੍ਰੋਕਸੀਮਿਟੀ ਦ ਸੈਂਸੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਪੀਸ ਔਰ ਆਫ ਆਨੰਦਾ ਇਜ ਦ ਸਿਮਟਮ ਆਫ ਸਤਸੰਗਾ ਟੈਨ ਆਈ ਆਸਕਡ ਹਿਮ ਟੂ ਟੈਲ ਮੀ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਹਿਜ ਸਟੇਟ ਹਿਜ ਆਂਸਰ ਵਾਜ ਕਲੀਅਰ ਕੱਟ ਐਂਡ ਐਕਸਪ੍ਰੈਸਿਵ ਆਫ ਦ ਅਸੈਂਸ ਆਫ ਦ ਸਵੀਟ ਨੈਕਟਰ ਆਫ ਐਟਰਨਲ ਲਾਈਫ ਇਲੈਵਨ ਆਈ ਕੁਡ ਨੋਟ ਪਰਸ਼ੂ ਦ ਕਨਵਰਸੇਸ਼ਨ ਦੈਨ ਐਂਡ ਫੈਲਟ ਲਾਈਕ ਏ ਬੈਗਰ ਮੇਡ ਬਿਫੋਰ ਏ ਕੁਈਨ ਹਾਊ ਐਵਰ ਆਈ ਪ੍ਰੇਡ ਟੂ ਹਿਮ ਐਂਡ ਹੀ ਡਾਇਰੈਕਟਿਡ ਮੀ ਟੂ ਦੀ 12 accordingly I have sought shelter at thy holy feet just as a blind man who is entirely dependent on his friends 13 what Samvarta said is not at all clear to me I have learned the gospel of Tripura well it is undoubtedly an incentive to devotion to her 14 she is incarnate as thou and always abides in my heart but what I have gained after all prayers to god are only selfish in the beginning yet they not only fulfill one's desires but also purify the mind so that devotion to god grows in intensity and the devotee desires nothing more than god then god shows his grace by manifesting as his guru 15 lord kindly explain what samvarta told me before it is certain that I cannot realize the goal until it is made known to me 16 whatever I do in ignorance thereof looks like mere child's play. 17. Formerly I pleased the gods, including Indra, with various ceremonies, observances, gifts, and presents of food. 18. Later I heard Samvarta say that the fruits of all these acts are only trivial. I consider those acts of no account which yield only trifling results. 19. Misery is not absence of happiness, but limited happiness. For as happiness recedes, misery pours in. 20. This is not the only miserable result of action, but there remains a still worse one, the fear of death, which cannot be mitigated by any amount of activity. 21. My devotional practices before Tripura are similar. All these mental conceptions are nothing but child's play. 22. The practices may be according to thy instructions or different. Again, they may be with discipline or without discipline, since the Shastras differ about this. 23. Meditations may also differ according to individual tastes and temperaments. How can that be? Devotion is just as imperfect as karma. 24. How can transient mental concepts of devotion produce intransient results of high truth? Moreover, the practices are continuous and there seems to be no end to these obligatory duties. 25. I have noticed that Samvarta, the Lord, is quite happy being completely free from any sense of obligation to act and its disastrous results. 26. He seems to laugh at the ways of the world, to stride unconcerned up the road of fearlessness, like a majestic elephant refreshing itself in a lake of melted snow when the surrounding forest is on fire. 27. I found him absolutely free from any sense of obligation and at the same time perfectly happy in his realization of eternal being. How did he gain the state and what did he tell me? 28. Kindly explain these points and so rescue me from the jaws of the monster of karma. 29. Praying so, he fell prostrate and took the master's feet in his hands. Seeing Parsurama doing so, the master felt that he was now ready for realization. 30. Sri Datta, whose very being was love, said gently, O child Bhargava, lucky are you, your mind being thus disposed. Stanza 31-33. Just as a man sinking in the ocean suddenly finds a boat to rescue him, so also your virtuous actions of the past have now placed you on the most sacred heights of self-realization. That Devi Tripura, who is the conscious core of the heart and therefore knows each one intimately, swiftly rescues her unswerving devotees from the jaws of death after manifesting herself in their hearts. Stanza 34. As long as a man is afraid of the nightmare obligation, so long must he placate it, or else he will not find peace. Stanza 35. How can a man stung by that viper obligation ever be happy? Therefore, some men have gone mad, as if some poison had already entered their blood and were torturing their whole being. Stanza 36. While others are stupefied by the poison of obligation and unable to discriminate good from bad. Stanza 37. Wrongly do they ever engage in work, being deluded. Such is the plight of humanity, stupefied by the poison of the sense of obligation. Stanza 38. Men are from time immemorial being swallowed up by the terrific ocean of poison, like some travelers once on the Vindhya range. Stanza 39. Oppressed by hunger in the forest, they mistook the deceptive Nux Vomica fruits, Vismushti, for some delicious oranges. Stanza 40. And in their voracious hunger, they ate them up without even detecting their bitter taste. They then suffered torment from the effects of the poison. Stanza 41. Having originally mistaken the poisonous fruit for an edible fruit, their reason being now blinded by poison, they eagerly sought relief from pain. Stanza 42. And in their agony, they took hold of and ate thorn apples, thinking them to be rose, apples. Thorn apples are used for extracting a poisonous alkaloid. The fruit is either fatal or produces insanity. Stanza 43. They became mad and lost their way. Some, becoming blind, fell into pits or gorges. Stanza 44. Some of them had their limbs and bodies cut by thorns. Some were disabled in their hands, feet, or other parts of the body. Others began to quarrel, fight, and shout among themselves. Stanza 45. They assaulted one another with their fists, stones, missiles, sticks, etc., till at length, thoroughly exhausted, they reached a certain town. Stanza 46. They happened to come to the outskirts of the town at nightfall and were prevented by the guards from entering. Stanza 47 to 49. Unaware of the time and place and unable to gauge the circumstances, they assaulted the guards and were soundly thrashed and chased away. Some fell into ditches, some were caught by crocodiles in deep waters, some fell headlong into wells and were drowned. A few, more dead than alive, were caught and thrown into prison. Stanza 50. Similar is the fate of those who, deluded with the quest for happiness, have fallen into the snares of the taskmaster of action. They are bewildered in their frenzy and destruction awaits them. Stanza 51 and 52. You are fortunate, Bhargava, in having transcended that distracted state. Investigation is the root cause of everything, and it is the first step to the supreme reward of indescribable bliss. How can anyone gain security without proper investigation? Stanza 53. Want of judgment is certain death, yet many are in its clutches. Success attends proper deliberation, till eventually the end is without doubt accomplished. Stanza 54. Indeliberateness is the ever-present weakness of the Daityas and Yatudhanas, Asuras and Rakshasas. Deliberation is the characteristic of the Devas, gods, and therefore they are always happy. Stanza 55. Owing to their discrimination, they depend on Vishnu, and inevitably conquer their enemies. Investigation is the seed capable of sprouting and flourishing into the gigantic tree of happiness. 50 stanza 56. A deliberating man always shines over others. Brahma is great because of deliberation. Vishnu is worshipped because of it. Stanza 57 and 58. The great Lord Shiva is omniscient for the same reason. Rama, though the most intelligent of men, came to disaster for want of judgment before attempting to capture the golden deer. Later, with due deliberation, he spanned the ocean, crossed over to Lanka, the island of the Rakshasa brood, and conquered it. The reference is to the Ramayana. Ravana, the arch enemy of Rama, induced one of his lieutenants to assume the shape of a golden deer and entice Rama away from his hermitage so that Ravana could forcibly carry away Sita, who would thus be left unprotected. The ruse succeeded, and later the great battle ensued in which Ravana and others were killed and Sita was recovered. Thus did Rama vindicate himself. Stanza 59. You must have heard how Brahma, also becoming on an occasion infatuated, acted rashly like a fool and consequently paid the penalty with one of his five heads. Note: Brahma originally had five heads. He and Vishnu were once contesting each other's superiority. Just then a huge column of light appeared in front of them and they wondered what it was. They agreed that he who found either end of the column earlier would be the greater of the two. Vishnu became a boar and sought the bottom. Brahma became a swan and flew up towards the top. Vishnu returned disappointed. Brahma, at the point of despair, came across a falling screw pine flower. He stopped its descent and asked from where it was coming. All that it knew was that it was falling from space and nothing more. Brahma persuaded it to bear false witness and claimed superiority over his rival. Shiva was enraged, sniffed off that head which spoke the lie, and declared himself as the column of light. Stanza 60. Unthinkingly, Mahadeva conferred a boon on the Asura and was immediately obliged to flee in terror for fear of being reduced to ashes. Note, there was once an asura by name Bhasma. He did penance and pleased Shiva, who appeared before him and asked him what he wanted. Bhasma desired that his mere touch should reduce any object to ashes. Shiva conferred the boon. Bhasma wanted to test it on him. Shiva took to flight in order to save him from that predicament. Vishnu appeared as a voluptuous damsel before the pursuing asura and enticed him. He became amorous and made advances to her. She asked him to go to a spring in front of them and rub himself with water before embracing her. He was taken in. On his hand touching his body, he fell down a heap of ashes. Stanza 61. On one occasion, Hari, having killed the wife of Bhrigu, became the victim of a terrible curse and suffered untold miseries. Stanza 62. Similarly, have other devas, asuras, rakshasas, men, and animals become miserable by want of judgment. Stanza 63. On the other hand, great and valiant are the heroes. O Bhargava, whom judgment ever befriends, eternal homage to them. Stanza 64. Common people, becoming foolishly involved with regard to their sense of action, are perplexed at every turn. If, on the other hand, they think and then act, they will be free from all misery. Stanza 65. The world has been in the coils of ignorance from time immemorial. How can there be discernment so long as ignorance lasts? Stanza 66 to 68. Can the sweet waters of dew collect in tropical sandy deserts which are already scorched by heat? Similarly, can the refreshing touch of discernment be sought in the rat horde flew over the furnace of long burning ignorance? Discernment is, however, gained by proper methods, the most effective of which is also the best of all, and that is the supreme grace of the goddess who inheres as the heart lotus in everyone who has ever accomplished and good purpose without her grace. Stanza 69. Investigation is the sun for chasing away the dense darkness of indolence. It is generated by the worship of God with devotion. Stanza 70. When the Supreme Devi is well pleased with the worship of the devotee, she turns into Vichara in him and shines as the blazing sun in the expanse of his heart. Note, Devi, goddess. Vichara, discrimination, investigation, deliberation, judgment. Devi is there in ignorance, in worship, in vichara, and later, like fat in the milk, the curds, and the churned butter successively. Stanza 71 and 72. Therefore, that Tripura, the Supreme Force, the being of all beings, the blessed, the highest, the one consciousness of Shiva, who abides as the self of self, should be worshipped sincerely, exactly as taught by the Guru. The forerunner of such worship is devotion and praiseworthy earnestness. Stanza 73-76. The antecedent cause of these is again said to be the learning of the Mahatmya. Therefore, O Rama, the Mahatmya was first revealed to you. Having heard it, you have now progressed well. Vichara is the only way to attain the highest good. I was indeed anxious about you, and therefore is very good reason for such anxiety until the mind turns towards vichara from the overpowering disease of ignorance, just as one is anxious about a patient who is delirious until one sees that his health shows signs of a favorable turn. Stanza 77. If once vichara takes root, the highest good has for all practical purposes been reached in this life. As long as vichara is absent from a human being, the most desirable form of birth, so long is the tree of life barren and therefore useless. The only useful fruit of life is vichara. Stanza 79-81. The man without discrimination is like a frog in a well. Just as the frog in a well does not know anything either of good or of bad, and so dies in his ignorance in the well itself. In the same way, man vainly born in Brahmanda do not know either good or bad regarding themselves and are born only to die in ignorance. Stanza 82. Confounding dispassion, vairagya with misery, and the pleasures of the world with happiness, sukha, a man suffers in the cycle of births and deaths while powerful ignorance prevails. Stanza 83 to 84. Even though afflicted by misery, he does not cease further indulgence in those causes antecedent to it, namely wealth, etc. Just as a jackass pursues a she-ass even if kicked 100 times by her, so also is it with the man and the world. But you, O Rama, by discriminating, have transcended misery. Thus ends the second chapter in Tripura Rahasya. Thank you for watching this video. Namaste, my dear friends. Next video number 4 will start with chapter 3, the antecedent cause for learning the gospel. Association with the wise must precede vichara. Namaste, namaskar.